Hi, and I'm here with Bill Height, who's founder and CEO of Whole Speed Associates. Currently, you spend most of your time in Munich, I believe.
Where I live.
And but you actually go back and forth. I understand there are 7 locations, but you go back and forth between Boston and Munich primarily. Is
yep,
that true?
That's true.
If you think about the traditional parts of business, you know, management, I'm talking about academically, yep, marketing, management, accounting, finance, and so on. Which one or two of those areas has been most important in your success, whether you acquired that knowledge here or afterward?
That's a really good question. So now I'm going to turn this around. I would not have been able to do what I did early on had I not had the education I did from here. And I'm not trying to plug the university, it's a reality. I walked away with a top-notch education. Even though I had mediocre grades, even though I had to take a lot of classes over again, and there was a reason for that, I worked. Right? But I walked away with a great education. So that to me was a foundation. So that accounting degree that I had was a great foundation. And then on top of that, as you excel in your career, you start managing people. So then you start getting into management and leadership. You're responsible for HR, then you get into management, leadership, law, regulation, and then, like I do now, I own and run my own company, and then, next thing you know, I'm responsible for marketing and sales along with everything else. And as you can see, in my situation, it's all the above. Even IT.
What's your favorite book that has anything to do about business? Fictional, non-fictional?
Good to Great.
Good to Great, okay. Now there are lots of different, get the right people on the bus, those sorts of things. What piece of Good to Great do you use or you know, even talk about?
So you said the first one was get the right people on the bus, and then you put them in the right seat when they're on the bus.
Okay. That's cool. Well, you've been successful as a leader.
okay.
Is a leader, well, you have a successful company, which you CEO, you
like. It's growing, it's growing.
So, philosophically, is a leader born or made?
I come from the school where they're made. You make yourself. I think we're born with some innate ability. Classic example. My father-in-law and I have very similar career tracks, but my father-in-law is more introvert and I'm more extrovert. So his leadership abilities and my leadership abilities, but specifically our styles, can be quite different. So that's the innate part. That's what we're born with. But you know, for the rest, if you want to be a leader, man, focus on it and be a leader.
Is it better to be an extrovert or an introvert? Introvert to be a leader. Either way.
You tell me.
Just a different style?
You tell me. You know, successful leaders fall into specific categories. Let's not get into, this is more, now we're getting into a large philosophical conversation.
That's good.
I've read too many Harvard MBA books, sorry. It has a lot to do with how a person is a leader in an environment and how that fits. I mean, I do have learning disabilities. It's not a cliche, it's a reality.
Well, then how does somebody go from being a student with some academic challenges to a success?
A lot of hard work, okay. Period, end of story. And it was, I knew once I got out of school that I would be fine, and I was lucky enough to be handed a couple of critical opportunities that I took and ran with it. It was a lot of work. I worked a lot of hours, but I knew at the end what I wanted to do and where I wanted to be, and I had used, you know, logic and kind of a typical career path to get there. 3 years of public accounting, and then I worked for an investment management company and gained a lot of SEC compliance experience. I did a lot of financial reporting, a lot of tax reporting, and then did an IPO. A lot of mergers and acquisition deals. I was responsible for HR, so that came with a new host of regulatory and law So it just kind of ballooned from there. And each step of the way, I tried to find that unique niche that would make me different than everybody else, that made me not indispensable, but made me so unique that it really added to my skill set. Because you know, I did. I had a reading problem. I still have it. I still have to read emails 3 times to make sure that I understand what I'm reading, and I have to go back through and re-edit all of my emails to make sure that I don't miss words, and I always do. But you fight, and I've kind of fought myself to where I am now. It has not been easy. So.
Well, then if one of the things that we're expected to teach in an AACSB accredited school is actually ethics.
Yeah.
In this global economy, then, if there is sort of different moral, yeah, ethical standards, can we effectively teach ethics to our students?
Yeah, I mean, one of the things that I would suggest is have people develop their own personal moral code. Because at the end of the day, that's one thing that people cannot take from you. Sounds like a movie, doesn't it? But it's true. And that's how a cult, for example, the culture of a company will start from one person's, for example, moral code, my company, for example. So the culture within my company, a lot of it comes from my own personal moral code and my own beliefs on how a company should be and how we are for our clients and in front of our clients.
That's great, and we hope to have you back sometime. This is William Hite, founder and CEO of Hull Speed Associates.
Great.
Thanks.
Thank you.